everyone. Welcome to another series of Build and Deploy. My name is Mitesh Bhopale, and I'm the Cloud Architect with Oracle for Startups Global Program. Today, we'll talk about one of our Oracle for Startups customer, UniCreate's successful journey to Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. I'm joined by the co-founder and COO of UniCreate, Rakesh Srivastava. So Rakesh, to get started, can you please brief us a little bit more about UniCreate?
Thanks, Mitesh, for having me here. UniCreate is a data extraction automation company. We help businesses maximize the value of unorganized data. A lot of this data is available across millions of documents varying in structure, context, layouts, and formats. Organizations spend a lot of time extracting this most relevant information using either hundreds of manual resources or using technical teams. Either approach takes a lot of time and is limited in scalability. This is what UniCreate addresses using AI learning system, intelligent workflow, and web-enabled interface.
So Rakesh, could you tell us more about what workloads you are running on OCI?
We have been part of OCI startup program from last year. And so far, we have been running 16 CPU instances and 3 GPU instances for each of our client environments. This addressed our basic need of 200 extraction cycles per day, with model training running every 24 hours. We managed to migrate the entire setup to OCI in just 4 days and have been able to provide maximum availability and uptime.
So it's a very good platform to talk about the technical architecture on OCI. So could you please walk us through the technical architecture?
So UniCreate follows a layered approach. We have a web server, the core manager, prediction engine, process monitor server, file storage, and our database server. Web server provides the extraction UI and administrative capabilities. DB server provides persistent storage for web server. Our core manager decides shape of VMs to be launched for the prediction engine. Prediction engine runs our AI and ML modules, whereas the monitoring server monitors the health and performance of our entire system. File storage provides scalable, low latency storage of models and document metadata. This effectively decouples from our web server and DB server. This automation was achieved using Ansible script to dynamically launch the desired shape of our prediction engine. The scalable prediction engine helps us address the challenge of processing 200-page documents based on the client's needs. The virtual cloud network here, where VM is hosted, are segmented into 2 subnets. Public subnet for Bastion server, which provides us an SSH connection to our cloud network. It also hosts our Jenkins server for our continuous integration and deployment requirements. Private subnets are for all VMs which do not require public access, such as our core manager, our prediction engine, file storage, and MySQL database managed servers. There is 2 levels of security implemented. The first layer is the network security implemented using network security list. Second layer is the application specific implemented using network security group for each network segment. You'll also notice different availability domains are configured for different components in the architecture. This further enabled fault tolerance in the same region. This mitigates the risk of all components in architecture not being available in case an AD site goes down. All environments are hosted with DR sites replicated in different regions. User access to the environments is managed through ID and access management, with strict policy implementation for each user. Object storage is used efficiently for all environment backups, including images of each VM.
So Rakesh, my next question will be, what drove the decision to migrate the workload to Oracle Cloud?
See, actually the volume and variety of different capital market use cases required us to be agile in scaling the compute bandwidth and storage. And OCI's off-the-shelf CPU configuration gave us higher compute power with a very competitive cost. The scalable file storage, MySQL managed services, object storage, addressing all our storage needs. And OCI's compartment approach provided us an efficient way to manage separate environments in the same region. We were also able to efficiently manage CPU instances for manager nodes, GPU instances for ML training modules, and overall, it has helped us achieve a monthly savings of approximately 20%, and that too with a very heavy usage.
So what's next for UniCreate on OCI?
Keeping in mind the huge volume of documents, which ranges from 5 to 10 million documents per annum per client to be processed by our engine, our key focus now will be on improving the training time and the performance of the models. Having tried all sorts of machine learning and deep learning algorithms, including TF-IDF, random forest, text embedding models, neural nets, and many other deep learning models, we have now been able to create a more advanced model to provide better context and representation of the text. This would require us to be more robust in our infrastructure now. In the next few weeks, extensive tests is planned on GPU to select the best possible scaling infrastructure, which is seamless, cost efficient, and yet robust in performance and throughput.
Brilliant. Thank you, Rakesh, for such good inputs. It's been a pleasure to chat with you. Thank you everyone for joining today. Stay tuned for more customer-related conversations on Build and Deploy video series.